We need a device to store electrical energy or to store energy in the form of electrical energy. How can we store it? So energy storage has been a matter of concern for all of us. Capacitor is a device in which we can store energy. How we store energy? In a capacitor. See, capacitor is basically a metal plate, nothing else. On that metal plate, we store charge. Storing charge. How do we store energy? Store energy by storing charge. If I have this plate, metal plate, and I carry few charges to it, then the moment I give it certain charges and carry more charges, then these charges will repel it like a spring. Then I have to push it, apply a force, do the displacement and put the charges here. That means I am doing some work. I am using my energy in pushing it, and after some time I push them here. If I push them here, then my work, my energy which I have transformed in work to put them here, that energy is stored here. Now I put more charges. Now all these are repelling it back, and I have to increase my force. Again, increasing the force, doing the displacement, I put them here. When I put and lock them here, then what has happened to my energy which I have spent in doing the work? Answer, that energy is transferred into this. Okay. Now, another thing happens. When we place charges here on this metal, a lot of charge is there. Initially, when there was no charge, its potential difference with reference to Earth. For Earth, we take as potential zero. For infinity, potential zero. For Earth, potential zero. So with reference to Earth, its potential difference was zero. Now, when I see the potential difference between this body and Earth, now I find it has gained a lot of potential. How much is that potential? That potential, we know the formula, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r. This is the potential of a shell, or sorry, of a ball, of a sphere, of any material. This is the potential. Now, if this charge is increasing, what will increase? Potential. If I put a potentiometer here, if I put a voltmeter here, this will show me that this voltage goes on increasing. Why the voltage goes on increasing? Because I am increasing the charge. I cannot see with my eyes the charge is increasing, but I can always see the voltmeter. If the voltmeter indicator is increasing, what is this indication for? The charge is increasing. So I am giving charge to it, and I see the potential is increasing, and now I can understand that my energy is being stored here. After some time I stop, and this potential has increased to V, and now I say this sphere is a charged sphere. This charged sphere is carrying charge, is at a higher potential, and it contains all the energy which I have given to it. Suppose we will calculate it, how much is the energy stored in it later, but now you can understand that we are in a position to store energy to a metallic plate if we have a device by which we can transport charge here by pressing it. Like, I can connect it with a battery, I can connect it with a dynamo which will press charge into it, and their energy is transferred into this material energy. And friends, this is capacitor. Why? because it has a capacity to do the work. Capacity to do work. Who can do work? Who has energy? So this has energy. Okay, so this has capacity to do the work, and therefore this is a capacitor. So this way, now if I want it to work, to give back my energy, what I will do? Here I will put a bulb and connect it with the earth, which is V is equal to 0. Its potential is V is equal to V. This is high potential, this is low potential, and we have learnt, or remember it now, a charge, they will repel each other and they will flow from higher potential to lower potential. I will remind you once again, if this is electric field here, what does it mean? There is a body here with positive charge, a body here in negative charge. So this is direction of electric field. If this is direction of electric field, then there are these equipotentials, V lines or equipotentials. This is higher potential, close to it, lower potential, still lower potential, negative potential. So this is, the potential is decreasing in this direction. Now, I place a positive charge here. What will happen? We can learn it by two methods. Number one, this charge Q will experience a force because of electric field, and this force is QE. Because of this force, it will move like this. Okay. Other, due to repulsion, it moves like this. So, I say a charge moves from higher potential towards lower potential. This is, you must remember it, it's a thumb rule. Which charge? Positive. Whenever we say charge, means positive charge moves from higher potential to lower potential. Okay, I remember this. Now, I come here. This is a higher potential, this is a lower potential. Charge will move here, and when the charge moves here, it has to go through the bulb, and the bulb brighten up. We get the light from the bulb. Getting light from the bulb is, bulb is working. Because somebody has given it energy. Who has given it energy? This, and what we call it? Capacitor, because it has capacity to do the work. So, what does a capacitor do? Capacitor stores energy. And what is this made of? This is made of metal plate. How does it store energy? We press charge into it, and whatever work we do, that energy is stored in it. What is indicator? That energy has been stored because we cannot see the charge. The indicator is potential difference. Its potential will increase, which we can see by the meter. So that will show that it has got energy. So this is introduction of a capacitor. In the next lecture, we will see what are the types of capacitor, so that we can store more and more energy into it, and it is convenient for us to take back that energy whenever we need it. Thank you.